Hello everybody and welcome to yet another episode of One Credit Champ, the show where we only do second takes when it's really necessary. And oh boy, was it really necessary this time. Oh well, what are we playing today? And today's game is Slatteryhouse, so shall we put the credit in? If you say so, son, let's press start and let's go. Now, Rick and Jennifer decided to go into the woods towards a haunted mansion. Jennifer got captured by some evil force or ever, and Rick died, and this mask has brought him back to life as some kind of hulking brute who doesn't look at all like any movie character ever. Now, this ancient terror mask that for some reason looks like a hockey mask despite the fact that it has no reason to, wills Rick on to explore the mansion and defeat lots of monsters by twatting them with cleavers and planks of wood. Because let's face it, who doesn't want to do that now and again? Now, this game caused quite a stir back in the day because of its goriness. I mean, it really doesn't look that gory when you look at it now, especially in comparison to the stuff that we have nowadays. But you think back, 1988, nobody had seen anything quite as splattery as this. And in fact, if rumours are to be believed, it was banned in certain arcades in the United States, although I can't honestly believe that was true because there was no organisation set up to monitor things like that back in those days, so any arcade operator could get hold of the board, put it in a machine and that's it really. Still, I'm sure it caused quite a furore with some people. Oh, ban this sick filth. Yes. Filthy, filthy filth. Look at it. Just covered in filth. Whether or not all that guff is true or not, who knows, but when it got a home release in the US on the TurboGrafx-16, it was slightly edited from its PC Engine original. The mask was changed, I assume, to stop certain movie studios trying to sue them, but also a few of the enemies were changed and so were the weapons. One of the later enemies is a inverted cross. And everybody knows the religion falls right out of a cross if you turn it upside down, so you do not do it. Look, you just spilled God all over the floor, now clean it up. I wonder how you clean religion off a floor. I bet it's messy and very shiny. Never mind that though, what were we doing? Oh yes, killing monsters, that's what we were doing, killing lots and lots of monsters. What else can I tell you about Slatteryhouse? Well, it got a couple of sequels. Never in the arcade though. For some reason, Slatteryhouse 2 never came out in the arcade. It came out on the Mega Drive, or if you're one of those foreign types that can't pronounce Mega Drive, the Genesis. Now, Slatteryhouse 2 played almost exactly the same as the first one, but with different levels. And then they released Slatteryhouse 3, which played more like a Streets of Rage style beat-em-up where you could walk in and out of the screen. But the problem was, it was absolute tat. They tried to give you more of a free roam option where you could explore each floor of the mansion at your leisure, but it really wasn't that good. The only good thing to come out of that game is the line, "Jennifer smells of rot from the grave." Indeed. Now this stage, this is the one that I remember the most fondly from the times when I used to play this at an old video store. Now that sound effect right there, that one. Yes, that sound effect I used to think was one of the greatest sound effects I had ever heard in a video game at that point in time. There's something about the way it echoed through the cabinet while it was being played on shitty speakers that made it really, really impressive. I mean, it's an impressive sound effect even now, but you're not quite hearing it the way I heard it. We're coming up to a certain boss that I'm kind of dreading, because I don't know if I can remember the pattern exactly. As we've mentioned time and time before on One Credit Champ, and for that matter games from the Chippy before it, if you can't remember a certain pattern, you can be completely fucked and lose your credit, and I've got a feeling that that might happen now. Anyway, this is kind of the boss for this level. We've got to avoid all the falling stuff from the ceiling at first. Right, that'll stop in a minute. Okie dokie, then a chair comes to life, and if I stand here, I can punch the chair, and I usually have no problems if I punch the chair from here, that should be good. And then the blades that you can see sticking out of everything come to life. Right, okay, we do this, and those other two will come to life in a minute. There they go. Oh shit, almost got hit there. Right, I should have them in the right position now to be able to punch them. Good-o, good-o, good-o. the painting's going to come alive. This is where I have the problem. I can't remember how to kill the painting. I don't know which position. Oh, shit. Well, I only have one unit of energy, so I didn't really have much of a chance at that point in time. Let's try that again, shall we? Get up, Rick. No dozing on the job now. Let's go over here. Let's avoid all the candles and the paint pots. Why the fuck there are paint pots all of a sudden appearing on the ceiling? I don't know. I just got hit by one as well. That's not good. That's not a good start. Wanted to keep all my health for the painting, but never mind. Right, punch the chair. Punchy punch chair. That's done. Now the blade. Now the first blade, at least. I'm going to have two in a second, aren't we? Here they come. Ooh, get out of the way. I want them both facing me on the same side. That's the badger. Only a couple more hits to go. Come on. Done that one. Let's kill him. Now the painting. Where the fucking hell are we supposed to stand for the painting? I can't fucking remember. Shit. Lost all my health again. The embarrassing thing about this is I know that out there somewhere there is somebody watching this video and shouting, you should be doing this right now, you should be doing that right now. And do you know why I know that? Because if this was 20 years ago when I still remembered how to play this game, it would be me doing the fucking shouting. But now I'm old, and some games where you just forget how to play them. Instead of being the expert you once were, you start looking like an old tramp trying to hit rubbish with a stick. On the bright side, I've just got myself an extra life. Well, that's nice and handy, isn't it? Especially if I lose again. Hopefully this time I won't, though. Punch the blades a couple more times, and then we've got the painting again. Here we go. Now, I know there is somewhere on this stage where I can just keep on punching and it just rebounds off the wall, but I can't fucking remember where it is anymore. I remember what happens after you defeat the painting. The chandelier falls off the fucking ceiling and you've got to get out of the way. But no, can I get that far? Can I fuck? Come on. One last go. One last fucking go. Let's do this. Let's get this fucking done. Okay, let's do this calmly and methodically. No panicking at all. Let's just punch this chair a few more times, then the blades come to life. Right, the first blades come to life. We'll just stand here. We'll just continue to punch it until the other two blades come to life. Right, we get out of the way of that one, and that's it. That's perfect. That is a perfect positioning, ready for when the painting comes to life. Oh fuck, it's hit me twice, it's hit me three times. Now we've got to punch. Fuck. Fucked up again. Piss. Oh, I'll put on aiming. Oh, well, on the bright side, I got the high score, didn't I? Although, considering what the lower scores are, that's not really much to toot my own horn about, is it? Oh well, bum. Continue? Of course not. We are going to leave Rick with his face in the dirt where he belongs. Oh well. Until next time. Bye!